Here's my old cutting board, and I want to make a wooden one a little bit bigger than this one, but I don't want to make it an end grain cutting board because those have to be really thick or they really warp. So I'm thinking of just making it out of solid wood, but with solid wood, if it gets wet on one side, it warps a bit. At least that's what I've experienced with this Tupperware lid made out of solid wood, whereas this one, which is made out of layers at right angles glued together, this one doesn't warp. And I want to make this out of white oak, but this is all the white oak I've got. So I'm going to have to be very careful slicing this up into thin layers to make my cutting board. I want to try to get 6 layers out of this, so I put a really thin skill saw blade in here. And hopefully I'll be able to cut some layers just 3 millimeters thick and get enough of them out of this piece. I ended up passing my workpiece over the jointer between making cuts just to get a smooth surface every time. And as a result, my sixth layer became unusably thin. So I used this scrap and I ripped a few more layers off of that. So I will use two of these pieces and one of these, and that should be big enough for the cutting board. I don't have enough white oak to make the whole cutting board out of it, so I just resawed some much less valuable red oak. And so this would be the bottom layer out of white oak. Then these go on here cross-grained to form the middle layer. And then we have another layer out of white oak. And the whole thing will go together a bit like plywood, and that should stop any warpage. I'm starting by gluing together the middle layers. These small clamps are there just to force the layers into alignment as I glue them. I figured while I'm waiting for the glue to dry, I might as well glue up the outside layers as well. Panel's all glued up. I think this sander will be handy for cleaning it up, but I don't have one. Well, that was a lot of elbow grease, but I think my panels are now flat enough for a glue up. Gluing strips against the end grain like this is normally a bad idea because as the wood shrinks and expands this way, this strip having grain this way won't shrink and expand, and they'll cause that glue joint to always fail. But in this case, this wood can't shrink and expand this way because the top and bottom layer, with the grain going this way, will prevent the layer in between from expanding. I've got a piece of plywood with a towel on it, and then some polyethylene to keep the glue away from my towel, because this being waterproof glue, it would ruin the towel. And polyethylene again, another towel, another piece of plywood, and now I can clamp all this. That's probably several tons of clamping force I've got in there. And I'm hoping with the towels providing some softness that that'll distribute the force evenly, so even if my cutting board isn't completely flat, it'll get squished together everywhere. I usually go and edit video while I'm waiting for the glue to dry, and so I've given this 2 hours now, so I think it should be okay to take the clamps off. Ah, it looks okay. Here's the finished sandwich with a red oak in the middle, and I'm going to hide that by adding a strip of white oak on the end like this. And I can get away with that because the oak can't expand and contract in this direction because it's being held in place by the long grain of the red oak in the middle, so that this joint should be good. I'm just filling some of these wormholes with sawdust and glue. Kind of wish I'd started with a better piece of wood, but I guess it's got character. But then again, to say it's got character, we usually say these things about things that are kind of ugly. Okay, enough of the elbow grease. It's power tool time. Now I need to finish this, and I'm just going to use a coating of vegetable oil. Now last time I used vegetable oil to finish something, people said, oh, that's bad for you, it's not food safe, it goes rancid, yada da 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 da. So I went to the Home Depot to look for something that was more food safe, and I started reading the warnings on the labels, and I decided that, you know, vegetable oil is probably the lesser of the evils. Yes, it does go rancid, and rancid vegetable oil is bad for you, just like trans fats are bad for you, but remember there was times when margarine made out of trans fats was considered safer than butter, so I think I'll be okay. I'm not planning on eating too many cutting boards, so I don't think I'm going to run into problems. I love the way the oil brings out the grain and the color of the white oak. But unfortunately, it also really highlights all the wormholes.